Jo. Okay. Hello everybody again. I hope you can hear me. I hope you can see me. If my lips are moving and you cannot understand what I'm saying, then please let us know early in the chat, for example. So, okay. Welcome to the Yocto live coding stream in October 2019. Actually, today will be a little bit special in terms that we won't do much coding, but a lot of explaining and a lot of housekeeping. In the last sessions, we often did cover things like machines, kernel, systemd, building SDK, and all that. And we often took the short route through local.conf. And this time, I'm trying to explain how to do it, to do things right, which is sometimes a little bit different. Okay, for everybody who's watching and listening to me, hi, I'm Joseph, also known as Lito the Second on GitHub and IRC, which brings me right to the next topic. We love interaction. So if you are watching, you have questions, comments, remarks, wanna propose to me or whatever, scroll down there and there's a list of ways you can get in touch with us. There's links to Twitter, to LinkedIn, to I think even to Facebook, and most importantly to the Freenode IRC. There's a link that takes you directly to the web front end where you pick a random nick of your least distrust, dislike, and you can instantly join us on #Yocto on Freenode and shoot us any questions or whatever you want to tell us. So, and concerning questions, I will take or try to take all kinds of questions, all kinds of remarks right during the sessions. Just shoot them into the Twitch chat or into IRC. I'll try to monitor those whenever I'm not staring at some code and trying to explain what it does. And yeah, so I think that's it to get started. So here we go. Let me get the right feed, and hopefully here it is. Yeah, I think you can see my terminal. Okay, well, I usually name it as the Holy Trinity of Open Embedded, and therefore also of Yocto. It's machine, distro, image. So how do those line up? What's the meaning behind them? In a nutshell, distro and machine are config files that tune the complete behavior of the build and the things that are going into the build. Whereas image is only a recipe. And we come back to the golden rule of Open Embedded. Conf data is global, recipe data is local. So, what does this mean in this case? Anything that has to affect more than just the things in the specific image that you are building. You have to think in recipes. The image is only a recipe. Let's stare at some code and you will see what I mean. Pocky. Voila, meta recipes core, hopefully images core image minimal. Here we go. It's a classic. So this is an image. The image defines what goes into the root file system, basically. So if you're listening to me and like at school taking down notes, please now write image equals contents of the file system. That's the bottom of it all. So if we are looking at this, we can see a summary, okay, which explains, but and then there's image install, in this case it says into the image will go package group core boot, which is exactly what it says. It's the absolutely core things of allowing the system to boot, mainly its busybox and some configuration files. And there's core image extra install. Core image extra install, you can see by the dollar sign and the braces, is a variable that can be fed from somewhere else. We will get back to the somewhere else in no time, but let's stick to the image for now. There's image linguas, which can define the locales that go into the image. The license is MIT, okay, hooray. It inherits core image, which basically pulls in all the mechanisms for an image to actually do the root file system creation. And it defines the image root FS size, which is a little bit strange. It actually is only needed if you are really creating a file system image like X4 or basically X4 and friends. If you're going for tar BZ2 or CPIO or whatever, then there is no root file system file size, because it's just the contents of the file system instead of the whole file system structure. Okay, so we can see it tells Bitbake, okay, get all the stuff and put it into the image. This is the image. Now, what's the next? I'm gonna check the chat just for a second. Okay. Q Schultz or whatever it's called. Hey, if you're listening, tell me your name, just so I know how to pronounce you. Okay. Next thing we're gonna look up is it the machine? I prepared a machine during the last session on kernels, where I kinda miserably failed in doing things right. But nevertheless, it will serve as a good demonstration item. As you can see, basically, I'm also streaming from the pub, as usual. So, really, just think like I'm your friend, coworker, whatever, sitting right next to you. And if you have questions, just interrupt me, and I will hopefully notice you and try to answer quickly. So we're gonna look at the machine I created last time. I named it Live Arm because I was doing a live session, and it's basically architecture ARM. I based it off QEMU ARM Cortex A15, and so we're gonna look at this for some time now. Generally, a machine configuration file shall define things that are needed to make a build actually work on a specific piece of hardware. You have to let this sink in for a bit. We are talking about settings that match the specific hardware in question. So, if we look this up now, this might explain some things. We are pulling in an include file. We will look at this specific include file right soon. And we define a kernel image type. Often we will also define, exactly, here we go, the image file system type, because in a lot of boards that you can actually get, there is a lot of restraints on how they can boot. For example, the Raspi, as our classic one and a lot of others need a small VFAT partition right at the beginning of the SD card, which has to contain some specific files, and from there on the bootloader can make things actually do something. So we are touching the topics of bootloader and kernel right now. In contrast to packages in the file system itself, bootloader and kernel are often quite locked down for a specific board. So that's another classic setting that goes into the machine.conf, the preferred provider for the kernel. And if you need a specific kernel modules, for example, so it actually can work, it usually goes here too. Machine essential extra R depends R recommends and all that. In this very special case, we also included a lot of things for run QEMU, but that's actually not that important. So I promised we will look at the include file, conf include. Hopefully I am in the right folder. I obviously am not. Tab edit, MetaLife, exactly, and that's where I didn't want to be. Pocky, is it there? Pocky conf machine include tune, exactly, and here you can see a lot of the tunes that already come with Pocky, and this time we're looking at Cortex A15. So these are the flags that actually get passed to GCC, for example, or Clang or whatever compiler you're using to optimize your code. So this is something that's also describing your hardware, the architecture and the specific things that it supports. For example, VFP, or Thumb, or Neon, or VFP, or whatever your specific SOC. We're really talking about specific chips by now. It's not guaranteed that any Cortex A15 has the same feature set, depending on the chip manufacturer. So this is really where you define what features of the processor you're going to use. We call this a tune, and there's a lot of predefined tunes that you could see in the include. And here you can actually dig into them and see what is set. Okay, another peek at the chats. So, what's the next thing to look at? It's a distro. In contrast to a machine configuration, which defines what shall be built and run on the actual board that you have, which can be seen as a lower layer, the distro actually defines the ABI. Basically, the application binary interface. It's probably the most restrictive interpretation of a distro. You could also say it defines the API, which gives you more degrees of freedom, but can lead to breakage if you are not only building special purpose distributions, but actually things that are running on a greater variety of hardware. Like if you are building stuff that can run on a Cortex A8, A9, A15, And for example, a thing that usually goes into a distro configuration is the choice of init system, which in my case usually is systemd. If I want to run something on a distribution that sets systemd, I can always rely on a dbus being there and a couple of binaries being populated so I can use them. So the distribution file basically defines what you can use to build your application. It's a bit hard to explain because it's not set in stone actually. It's more like a really best practice that has turned out through the years. If I can, an example from my daily work is that we also do set things that affect specific libraries through a distro.conf. Especially C++ libraries can either support C++ 11, C++ 14, C++ 17 features or not. And if that has to be defined during build time, which it often has to, then in our opinion, distribution.conf file is the way to go because it affects all the libraries that we are maintaining equally. And if we set feature set C++ 14, for example, then all our libraries that we're doing and that have an extended feature set for C++ 14 will be affected. So we are back to the golden rule. If you want to do something that affects more than one recipe, it has to go into a configuration file. And I think it's time to now look at the effects of the livearm configuration file, as discussed just a couple of minutes ago. And then we are going to create a live distro for the sake of doing things right today. And hopefully some more questions. As I said, we will be doing a lot of explanations and housekeeping today and not so much of actual coding. So let's look at it. Bake e core image minimal. Yes. So I'm gonna dump me the build of core image minimal into my list, hopefully. And then we're gonna check out what gets set by livearm. So here we go. Right at the top you can see how things are being pulled in hierarchically. Did I pronounce it right? Any native speakers? Don't tell me, I don't care. Okay, this is not exactly what we need to look at, but here we go. Here's something almost interesting. And here's something really interesting. You can see on image as types, there's three operations and a livearm.conf sets tarbz2 and ext4 as the file systems that will match our machine by the name of livearm. Then a lot of the batteries included stuff kicks in, namely documentation.conf tells us hooray, it's the formats of the root file system, and then bitbake.conf tells us if it's not set already, then go for a tarbz. But it is already set, so The image of S types will be tarbc2 and ext4. What's going on anyways? It sets the kernel image type in exactly the same way. It sets the K machine, which is especially required for the yoctoized kernels. Then it sets machine extra recommend, so we can pull in the kernel modules. I'm not sure if I actually discussed any kernel modules last time or if I only prepared it. It's not that important anyways. And here comes some of the really interesting stuff. It's the preferred providers for especially virtual kernel. It sets Linux stable as the thing to do. You can see right below, in this case, for example, virtual libc, so the libc that our build will be using is set to glibc. And think back about the things concerning the hardware and things concerning the application binary interface again. The glibc is certainly something that you use for application building, and I actually expect the interface to be stable across all my images, so it certainly should be set in some distro. And just like expected, it's in the distro. In this case, in a predefined distro, but nonetheless, here it is. So then here comes the QEMU ARM stuff, which is more like of a demonstration thing. I think we should see if it actually runs, because if not, then I will be sad. Mostly I want to be able to show the distro later. So checking into the chats for a second. The Yocto CLI tool used binaries to the distro. Are you talking about package management? I mean, that sounds basically like you want package management on your target, right? You are running something, and then you would be like apt-get mc, and then it should go out and pull in the things to install into your distribution on the target, right? I think that's probably the thing that comes closest to it. If you're talking about adding binaries and not defining things in configuration files or recipes. Correct me if I'm wrong. I think Mark mentioned toaster, but that's actually just a fancy front end, and it's not moving around binaries, it's just adding things to the recipes. And I actually don't believe in package management nor toaster, if I have to be honest, which I usually am, because your use case might be different. If you are an operating system vendor or a distribution vendor, then you will be taking care of things that run across a multitude of devices. Whereas in my daily work, I build distributions that are tailored to one specific application on one specific set of hardware. So there is no package management there because it all boils down into one binary blob that gets flashed into the device in our production lines, and then it goes out. I don't want any of the users or customers to go like, oh, okay, I want this bit and this bit and this bit. It's all one blob. There's nothing to be managed in there. And so for my use case, I don't believe in package management. And Toaster is how to pronounce it so is nobody is feels like annoyed by me. Is David around? I hope David Rayner is not listening by now. To me, Toaster is like a marketing tool. Toaster is like what you show folks if you want to convince them that the Eocto project is super cool and it even has a super fancy surface, a GUI even, to do all kinds of funny things and click and point and drag and drop and stare at your web browsers because web browsers are cool these days. But in the end, it's not exactly of production use for me, because usually you want to run a CI pipeline where something you push into your meta layers, your build configuration of whatever kind. I plan to talk about bigger build configuration systems at some future stream. But usually there's a lot of pipeline behind what you're doing. And this does not really mesh with Toaster. It meshes with text files in Git repositories. And so that's what we do. We do edit text files in Git repositories. We push them, and then all the machinery just goes like, hooray, something to do. And in at the other end of the pipeline, our binary blobs fall out. So while Toaster certainly has its uses, I don't see it as a lot of development tool. I see Mark calls it a build visualizer, which probably is the best way to word it. Yeah, thanks, Mark. As far as I know, I'm working on thin ice right now. As far as I know, you can take the build information from your CI/CD pipeline, pipe it to the Toaster database, and then use the Toaster frontend to actually visualize and see what's going on. So there might be use there. There's other ways to inspect what's going on in your automated builds. There has been a lot of improvements and new cool features by Richard and Josh. I think by Josh. I'm not sure. If you're getting the glory of somebody else, take it as granted. Where you can get a lot of information about where the time is actually being spent. So if you're interested in things like that, please hop onto the channel. It's time to mention it again. Scroll down there. There's a link to HashYocto on Freenode on IRC. It's super cool. It's totally old school. We have text-based chat and no emojis. If you've got a good client, you can even see colored nicks, but that's about it. On the other hand, you don't have to register or anything, just pick your favorite nickname, and here we go. You can shoot us questions anytime. Okay, I think I massively digressed. So, okay, my image boots. Just for the sake of shutting it down right now again, hopefully. And Let's do the small bit of live coding that I actually intended to do today. Let's build a distro. So here we are. By convention, all machines live in conf machine, name of the machine dot conf in a layer, and all distributions live in conf distro name of the configuration dot conf in a layer. So we gotta go there. Mkdir distro, cd distro, and then we're gonna call it live distro. distro.conf. And configurations files work like anything else in Open Embedded. They are parsed from top to bottom. That you can include and you can override stuff. And I'm not going to do a completely new distribution today. I'm just gonna extend Pocky to my needs for the session. If you're doing a really long-lived product or where you have to maintain your distribution over changing versions of Yoctor or Open Embedded, it might be better to not depend on Pocky, but nailing things down so you don't get bitten if Pocky actually changes between releases. But there's the subtle screws. And if you are thinking about things like that, then you can actually figure the breakage out anyways. So I think we're gonna require conf distro pocky.conf. Let's just see if that works. I'm totally not sure. I haven't broken anything yet, which is over half an hour already. Way too long for a proper live coding session. So we seriously need to break something now. Where's my distro? Distro, okay, here we go. Distro, live distro. Live distro. And then let's bitbake core image minimal and see what's going on. Time to drink. Build is churning, build is broken. Hooray! That's what I expected. Or? No, it isn't even broken. Why isn't it broken? I expected it to be broken. Okay. It worked way too well because we required and therefore inherited all of Pocky, which is not exactly what we want. So, let's also look at Pocky to figure out what we could change. Pocky meta conf distro Pocky, hopefully. No, it's meta Pocky conf distro Pocky conf. Okay, so. Oops. We're just gonna do some things right now. YVI, you are biting me, but that happens too. Okay, distro. Live distro. Live distro. Live coding. I think that sounds right. And we need a cool distribution name. What's a cool distribution name? Beer. We are doing things right now. We need beer. So we're gonna have a drink and we are gonna call this distribution beer. I hereby declare that this distribution is to be called beer. And we're gonna build again. For as we are doing things that are less serious on explaining and more on doing and breaking stuff. I haven't already mentioned in this session that in 3 weeks there will be the Embedded Linux conference in Europe, in Lyon, France, where you can actually meet me and a lot of the folks behind the Yocto project in person. So if you are attending, just watch out for us, say hello, tell us what we are doing good, tell us what we're doing bad, and concerning talking to us. If you have ever been to a Linux Foundation party, or you can see Live Arm, Live Distro, that sounds good. If you have ever been to a Linux Foundation conference, then you will know those funny stickers that they hand out for your badge. You get a badge, and they hand out stickers that tell others if you want to be talked to. I actually don't need those, but I find them quite funny, and I always get the blue ones because they have no meaning. They tell you red is for don't talk to me, yellow is you can talk to me but not right now, and green means yeah, talk to me anytime. And blue has no meaning, so I find that funny. But this year I declare that Linux, and especially Embedded Linux, has too little glamour. We need more glamour. And what has more glamour than glitter? So I will be bringing those to Lyon, which is glitter. Those are colored glitter smiley stickers, and I will be handing out those wherever I'm going, standing, talking to people. Just so if you meet me and want to put some glamour in your Linux stuff, ask me for a glitter sticker to put on your badge. I will also be depositing some of those at the Yocto booth if they don't kick me out. So you can get your conference dose of glamour right at the Yocto booth. Yeah. We need beer. And one more thing. I will be bringing along a couple of really small gifts, but only a handful, like 5 or 10 items, that I will also deposit at the Yocto booth, and instruct them to hand them out for whomever asks first. So if you are referring to the live coding sessions with me and ask for the giveaway, be hopefully fast, because they might be gone really, really soon. It's 5 items, 10 maximum, seriously. Stickers are more. I think I got like 300. Hopefully that's enough. So our build has finished. It's time to boot it up again. I see that the question is, what does Pocky actually include? That's a really good question. Pocky is like a big bucket of glue. I don't know who am I pissing off right at the moment. But actually, Pocky is like a big bucket of glue that is set up in a proper way so the build works. That's why it's called a reference distribution. If you take this and build it, it will work. Let's see what my personal distribution is doing, and then we're gonna look at what Pocky actually includes. Okay. Buckets of Lego. I'm not sure on this. I like Lego. Do you want a glitter sticker, Mark? I will spare one for you. Pick a color. I think I have pink. I have pink. Seriously. See this? This one's for you. Is the boot already finished? The boot is finished. Okay, so login. I can't pack away my stickers again. So actually, I just wanted to look into etc OS release, and here is exactly what I just set as my distribution. ID live distro, name, version, pretty name, and it includes beer, just as I promised. So we're gonna do two more meaningful things. We're gonna pull things out of the local.conf that don't really belong in there, and then we're gonna look at pocky.conf, and then my time is over anyways. I'm not gonna stay over time today because I've got another appointment, but we're gonna do this. Okay, so you can see this is stuff I have set in local.conf for demonstration purposes, and the name already should ring a bell here. Distro features. Distro features is, it's meant to go into distro features, right? So that's what we're gonna do. Gonna take all this out and put it into the distro. And that's where it's meant to go. That's what I meant with the ABI or slash API. Systemd or PAM are definitely part of the programming interface of an image, so they have to go into the distribution. You can select preferred versions of a compiler, for example. You can select preferred versions of libraries. You can also select preferred providers, as long as it's not affecting the hardware interaction. Let's say the preferred provider for a kernel or the bootloader should go into the machine.conf, whereas the preferred provider for the libc, for your GL implementation or whatever, should go into the distro. If I'm not super mistaken, and looking at the time, we can give it a try. Let's just for the laughs, let's set preferred provider virtual libc to muscle. I'm wondering that it will actually work, and then we can build a completely new distribution. It will have not completely, but different ABI, because Muscle's surface has some subtle differences from glibc, especially a more restrained feature set. And I'm not sure if we can actually finish the build, but I'm basically done with the core explanations anyway. You have to do the things to take away from this session is the image recipe defines what goes into the image. The machine configuration, hooray, I broke it. I think we can actually try and fix that. Things that define the needed adaptations to your hardware in question is shall go into the machine configuration, and things that define your interface for actual application developments have to go into the distro.conf. So this is the holy trinity: image, distro, machine. What is local.conf? Local.conf is your archenemy. Into local.conf, nothing should ever go which is required to reproduce the build. Let that sink in for a bit. Into local.conf, only stuff should go that is needed to execute the build on your specific specific machine, like where's estate, where's tempter, what image are what machine am I building for, what distro am I building for, and then stuff like eking out if your disk is full. Okay, this won't build. I'm seeing that was a stupid idea during the live code session, but at least I broke something. Seriously, if I'm not breaking stuff, I'm not feeling good. Local.conf is, you have to think about it like, do I need to hand it over to my coworker? If you need to write down in local.conf, that is so essential for your build that you can't just wipe it and then go away and leave a coworker to actually build it, then you're doing it wrong. Local.conf is not meant to bear any meaningful or any essential information. That's the gist of it. You have to you can use it as a thing for local tinkering. You want a quick modification, you want to pass in a variable, that's all fine. But when you are passing in things that are needed for anybody else to make things work again, then you're doing it wrong. Then you have to look at the line and see, is this affecting distro, machine, or image, and then put it there, and then put it into your layers. Okay. I'm actually wondering what I shall talk about now. Because that's what I wanted to tell you. I wanted to tell you, put everything into image. We wanted to look at Pocky. Sorry. I completely forgot. So, here's Pocky. Pocky is a little bit overly complex for a distribution, because it's all also the reference distribution and the most exhaustive one. So let's first look at Pocky Bleeding Edge, and then go back to Pocky. For explanation purposes, I think that makes sense. Distro, I'm wrong again, it's meta Pocky conf distro Pocky Bleeding. So you see, this is also a form of a derived distribution. It only sets preferred versions, it pulls in Pocky by itself and another include that we're not going to talk about today, and it sets the name, and that's it. So I'm gonna look at Pocky, and Pocky basically sets everything. It sets the distribution, all the things we looked at in OS release. It brings along its own maintainer, and you can already by looking at it see that it's meant to as a blueprint that you can take and beat into shape for your use case. Override these in Pocky-based distributions. This means like set your your distro, extra recommends and R depends as things that you actually need. It set your distro features. I mean, like, this is something I usually don't want on a small ARM system, right? What if I don't even have a display? Do I really want OpenGL, Whale, and the Vulkan? Probably not. This is something I personally would not suggest, But I think for testing purposes, Bruce or Mark can probably share some wisdom on it. I personally would expect the kernel version to be set in the machine, but as PoKy and the Linux Yocto kernels, which bring some specific modifications, are like working in closed step. I think it's a little it's fine in this case, and then it brings a lot of magic. Also, if you ever asked why Bitbake is annoying you about things not being compatible, here's why. And I think that's it. Then that is Pocky. Another look at the chat for me. Are we talking about DevTool right now, or any other questions that Mark has not already tackled for me? Question was for another tool. Yeah, but that the tool for doing what? Automated recipe building or what? I mean, I personally am using DevTool more like a development tool during application. Development, and I am, as I'm a super lazy guy, I usually do my recipes just copy pasta style. I skim the layer index or PoKy or Open Embedded if there's something already close to what I need, and then I beat it into shape for whatever need. A tool for image building, like menu config. No. Now I know what you mean. You're like Buildroot has, right? That's a pretty clear no, we don't have that. Toaster is closest, and but in generally no. Sorry to be this direct, but yeah. It's not there. Probably because of the massive complexity that gets introduced through the layers, it's not that that simple to actually put that into a configuration interface. You could basically do it if you are nailing down machine and distro. If you are nailing down machine and distro, then you could create just like a pick and match, for example, for only recipes that are packages that get pulled into the image. It's possible to some extent. The Angstrom distribution, which is actually a distribution built off Open Embedded, used to have something close to it. I think it was called Narcissus. I don't think Kuhn is watching. He would know. Which was like a web front end where you picked a machine and then said like this and this and this package I want in the image. Go build it. But it restricts your degrees of freedom massively. And so it's like Toaster. It's useful for getting a first glance as a marketing tool. Hey, it's super easy to build your distribution in like 10 clicks, but what comes out of it is not of any real value if you're doing embedded product development. And I guess that's also one of the core reasons for Yoctor not having it. The degrees of freedom in Open Embedded is so massive that pouring it into a configuration surface is just not going to work. There will always be some guy who will say like, but I want this setting here too, and then you're ending up like a configuration interface that bears all the complexity of the text files. Complexity is combinational. If you have two settings that each can have two meanings, then there will be four combinations in your interface. And I think that's the reason, the combinational complexity. Discord? Which Discord? We're not doing Discord, sorry. We're not cool. We're the old cranky Unix neckbeards sitting in our cellars. We like it dark, we like it dusty, and we're not doing Discord. We have IRC. Sorry. Just like I said, I don't have anything more prepared to explain. I think I'm gonna close the session then for today. Everybody who's joined late or listening right now, go meet us in #Yocto on Freenode on RC. There's a link to click right down there. I will be sticking around for like 10 minutes or so and then checking back laters. There's always folks and usually way more competent folks than me hanging out there that you can shoot all your questions and remarks, and we will always try to take care of all your needs. It might sometimes take some time, and we might sometimes tell you that you're on the wrong you're trying to do things in the wrong way. Yeah, that happens, sorry. But we will always try to be helpful. I think that's the main thing. We really try to be helpful. And meet us in Lyon. Most of the Yocto folks I know will be there. And remember to get one of those stickers. And with that, I say thank you for watching. Take care. And one more thing. We will be reformatting the stream probably in Lyon, like date and time, streaming platform, whatever. So if you have things to tell us about improving or changing the stream as it is, then please shoot those remarks too. We are happy to listen, and sometimes we even care. So with that, good night, bye bye.